The synagogue of Satan revealed. Let's dig into the Word of God right now. Now, the term synagogue of Satan is used two times in the book of Revelation. You'll find that in Revelation 2 and verse 9, Revelation 3 and verse 9, both times given by the Lord Jesus Christ. So it's very important that you understand this term, what he's trying to get across. You will see that he uses this term to describe a group of people who claim to be Jews, but they were not, okay? Revelation 2, verses 8 and 9. And unto the angel of the church in Smyrna write, these things saith the first and the last, which was dead and is alive. I know thy works, and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. Some heavy-duty stuff that the Lord is speaking to this church here, and very important that we understand. First of all, understand the first and the last, the one who was dead but is now alive, speaking of Jesus Christ. And you will see that the first and the last is describing Almighty God himself. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 44 and verse 6. Thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first and I am the last, and beside me there is no God. That's a great proof text, by the way, for the deity of Jesus Christ. It says the Lord, the King of Israel. We know that Jesus Christ is the King of Israel. It calls him his Redeemer, okay? His Redeemer. We know that the Lord Jesus Christ is the Redeemer without question. And it says, beside me there is no God. Isn't that incredible? So the first and the last describing the person of Jesus Christ. So when you hear him talk, we need to take heed to what he's saying. So he goes to this church in Smyrna, and he lets them know he knows what's going on. He knows that these people are fakers. Basically, they're describing themselves as Jews, but they are not. He knew of their physical poverty, but he lets them know that they were actually rich, meaning spiritually rich in God Almighty. Let's go to Revelation 3, verse 9. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie. Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet and to know that I have loved thee. So once again, we see that term is used describing people claiming to be Jews, but they were not. We see that the Lord was very well aware of that. Let me say today that the Lord is very well aware of those within any church that would call itself a Christian church. The Lord knows who's sitting in that church and who's real and who, in fact, is faking it. Now, it's very important that you see what I'm going to make a point here. John chapter 1, verses 11 and 12. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. So the Lord Jesus Christ, he came at a specific point in time, came into his own, speaking of the Jewish people, but they received him not. They rejected him. Most Gentiles reject Jesus Christ also. So the Jews reject Christ as Messiah. They did not receive him. But God gave them the opportunity back then and right now, and for the past almost 2,000 years, they have had that opportunity. For the most part, religious and secular reject Jesus Christ as being the Messiah. Oh, yes, they do. And, you know, there's a lot of talk that goes on today that says, you know, the church today, this was basically God's second choice, and the kingdom is postponed, and the church is a mere parenthesis in God's plan. That's hogwash, ladies and gentlemen. Do not buy that. That is nothing but dispensational heresy. It's being preached all over the airwaves. Jesus came at a certain point in time. He died. His blood can atone for your sins. The majority of Jewish people who claim to know God, they have no blood atonement. There's no temple. No temple sacrifices, no tabernacle. So they're missing the blood atonement, which is necessary for their sins to be atoned for. Do not ever forget that. So when you hear people calling ethnic Israel God's chosen people, do not buy it. You do not find that word chosen being used in the New Testament or the New Covenant describing the Jewish people. You see that term used only for those who believe in Jesus Christ. Do not ever forget that. Now, John the Baptist, how did he see it? Let's go to the scriptures. Matthew chapter 3, verses 7 to 9. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees come to his baptism, he said unto them, O generation of vipers, who hath warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bring forth, therefore, fruits meet for repentance. And think not to say within yourselves, We have Abraham to our father. For I say unto you that God is able of these stones to raise up children unto Abraham. There's a lot of talk, ladies and gentlemen, about the Abrahamic covenant, that it's everlasting. I agree with that. But it's only everlasting in Jesus Christ. Oh, yes. So in other words, you can't say you're under the Abrahamic covenant if you reject Jesus Christ. That's foolishness. If you reject Christ, then you're rejecting the whole kit and caboodle, if you want to say. Oh, yes. John the Baptist referred to the unbelieving Jews as vipers. He's calling them snakes. Oh, yes, he was. That's in the Bible for a reason. Ladies and gentlemen, God hates an outward profession. People going through religious tradition, but it's void of the power of Almighty God. These people, they were Jewish by nature. Okay, but they did not have God's word living and abiding within them. So John was not impressed with their Jewish heritage, as many are today in what you would call the church world. You know, Jesus also used the very same term to describe the people, the Jewish religious people who were rejecting him. In Matthew 23, verse 33, check it out. Ye serpents, ye generation of vipers, how can ye escape the damnation of hell? Those terms, ladies and gentlemen, these are serious terms. It's speaking of poisonous snakes. Snakes are very wily. They're very crafty in the way they move, and they can hurt you. They can kill you, okay? And that's the way false teaching and false doctrine is, okay? So John the Baptist and Jesus both spoke. They used those terms, vipers. My, oh my, take heed to what you're hearing here today, because it's so in opposition to what you're hearing on most what you would call Christian television stations today. So the Old Testament scriptures, ladies and gentlemen, they speak of Jesus Christ. Moses, the Psalms, the prophets, they testified of Jesus Christ. And when Jesus came to the religious people, listen to what he said. John chapter 5, I'll start at verse 37 through 40. And the Father himself, which hath sent me, hath borne witness of me. Ye have neither heard his voice at any time, nor seen his shape. And ye have not his word abiding in you, for whom he hath sent him ye believe not. Search the scriptures, for in them ye think ye have eternal life, and they are they which testify of me, and ye will not come to me that ye might have life. That's heavy duty stuff. Don't ever forget those scriptures. The Lord is basically saying to the Jewish people, he says, listen, you have the word of God. You have the scriptures. They had the Psalms. They had prophets. They had the books of Moses. And they were testifying. They were speaking about Jesus Christ. And he said to them, he says, you think you have eternal life, but you don't. They testify about me, but you will not come to me that you might have life. He's speaking about eternal life. They were dead in their sins. And ladies and gentlemen, that still applies today. Not only to the Jewish people, those scriptures apply to any person, Jewish or Gentile. The difference is, ladies and gentlemen, they were not born again of the Spirit. They had no life in them. Remember what Jesus said to the man Nicodemus? He said, you must be born again. In John chapter 3, verses 6 and 7, listen, that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again. Jesus was not impressed with the Jewish heritage of this ruler of Jews by the name of Nicodemus. He made it clear, got right to the point, cut right to the chase. Nicodemus, you must be born again. Listen to how Jesus dealt with the religious Jewish people who rejected him. John 8 and verse 44. Ye are of your father the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the meek and gentle Jesus Christ testifying now in front of the religious Jewish people. He says, your father is the devil. Ladies and gentlemen, those are not my words. Those are his words. They're in the Bible for a reason. It's the same principle that we find in the book of Revelation, the synagogue of Satan. These people were part of that synagogue. They were unbelievers. They rejected the one whom God the Father sent. Listen to what the Jewish apostle Paul said. He once was in opposition to the Christian. Severe persecutor, consenting unto the death of many of them. Romans 2, 28 and 29. For he is not a Jew which is one outwardly, neither is that circumcision which is outward in the flesh, but he is a Jew which is one inwardly, and circumcision is that of the heart and the spirit, and not in the letter, whose praise is not of men, but of God. Heavy duty. Same principle. It's a spiritual circumcision, ladies and gentlemen, that takes place in the heart. It's being regenerated by the power of the Holy Spirit. If you have never had that happen in you, you, whether you're Jewish or Gentile, you're still dead in your sins. You must be born again. Oh yes, you must be born again. You're either dead in your sins or you are alive in Jesus Christ. You know, all of this talk about the Abrahamic covenant. Abraham promised to be the heir of the world, not just limited to physical Israel. Romans 4:13. Galatians 3:16. Christ was the promised seed. Galatians 3:13. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. If you're trying to live by the law, you're under a curse. 3:29 Galatians. Only those who believe in Jesus Christ are counted to be the seed of Abraham. So there's a great deception, especially in Christian Zionism. You know, John Hagee, he made a statement that those Jewish people, who, as long as they live in light of the Torah, that they're in covenant with God. That is nonsense. Those people have a covenant with death. Oh yes, they are not in covenant with God unless they are in covenant with Jesus Christ and they receive him. The Bible makes it clear that people are condemned without him. People are damned without him. Unbelievers have the wrath of God on them. Jewish people will die in their sins without him. Gentiles also. Israel still rejects Jesus Christ and make God a liar. They do not have the spiritual life that God wants to offer them. Jesus said that they would die in their sins without him. This is heavy duty stuff, ladies and gentlemen. And in this modern day, there are many that would be claiming not to be Jewish, but claiming to know Christ. You have the Jehovah's Witnesses declaring themselves to be Christian. They say that Jesus was Michael the Archangel at one time. They claim that Jesus is not God, but a God. You have the Roman Catholic Church with their Mary worship, teaching of purgatory, the sacrifice of the Mass, and all the other traditions, man-made traditions, a false gospel. You have the Mormons, the Church of Latter-day Saints, the Mormons can become gods or little gods, I think they teach, that there's a mother god. These are false doctrines. These are false gospels. And you can equate these people also with being in the synagogue of Satan. The synagogue of Satan, ladies and gentlemen, is a humongous, large, spiritual, unseen synagogue. It's made up of people all over the world who claim to know God, but they do not know him. And that's basically what I want to get across to you in this message. Something else you need to know. An example that I can give you, a TBN, for instance, Trinity Broadcasting Network. They sell Roman Catholic books by the hundreds. Books about Mary, books about the Rosary, books about the sacrifice of the Mass. All of these things. And when you think, you read Fox's Book of Martyrs about the people who stood against that system. Rome still preaches the same false doctrines, but here is this so-called Christian television network selling their goods. The Lord called me out of that system. I'm a former Roman Catholic. So that's what I'm talking about when I speak about the synagogue of Satan. Very crafty. Remember how the Lord said serpents, vipers, poisonous false doctrines entering in. Beware, ladies and gentlemen, of this synagogue of Satan. Be blessed.